Superstition.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we inside opposition have summed the debate down for you into two key questions. Number one, where does the responsibility actually fall? And number two, how does it actually affect reintegration? Let's get straight into my first question, where does responsibility fall? So what we've heard from side government all across the bench today is that they think that religious groups should have the responsibility to provide for these people, to provide for their reintegration. We have a couple of responses to you for this. First of all, let's look at the person who like chooses to join. And we tell you that under this person who chooses to join, it's not their responsibility, it's not the cult's responsibility to pay for their reintegration fee. It was my decision to join the cult, it was my decision to give it all up, and therefore we think that it should also be that same person's responsibility to pay for everything when they want to reintegrate back. But then let's look at the person who was like born into the situation, and that, like, and we think that in this case, it's still not the cult's responsibility. Why is this? We tell you that just because I'm born somewhere, that doesn't mean that that place that I was born in has to take full responsibility for like taking care of every single one of my needs and my reintegration fees, right? For example, if I'm born into Africa and want to integrate into America, they don't pay for my fees that way. We think that even like in the same way, like cults, that they don't like provide education or don't provide proper healthcare. We think that like the place that you're born might not also provide those things. They don't pay for your integration into another country or a better lifestyle. Right? What we further tell you is that we think that furthermore, it's not only not just the, not the cult's responsibility, but it's actually also the government's responsibility, right? Tatiana already told you in her extension speech, like we found a huge contradiction inside government's case today. They tell you that the cult should pay, and at the same time they say that the government is the one that's giving them welfare. So in a sense then, isn't it true that the government is the one that should be taking responsibility and like providing this in the first place? We tell you that we furthermore think that like things that they bring up, like education and healthcare, those are already things that should be provided for by the government. Furthermore, we would tell you that we don't actually think that these religious communities have the actual means to provide for this support, and that's kind of what Tatiana's extension really talked to you about and really emphasized, and we think that that's actually a really key point in today's debate. We think that when we analyze what types of cults or religious communities these people are from, these are mostly like subsistence farming agricultural communities. They like don't have the means to provide a lot of money, thousands upon thousands of dollars, of being able to send their people who defect to like give them the money to reintegrate back into society. And what Tatiana told you in her extension is that now when we force them to pay for these people, we're actually going to turn benign groups into like more malignant ones. People who like want to like not let their people leave when they used to be okay with it. And we don't think that this is a good thing, right? They've tried to tell you, like on side government today, that like their whole case has been about minimizing harms. But under tax extension and under side opposition's house, we tell you that this is actually going to maximize the harms, and we don't think that this is a good thing. Okay, let's move into my second question, this idea about how does it actually affect reintegration? And what we've heard coming from side government is that this is going to give people the chance and the choice to like leave by providing money, because in the status quo, communities like beat you if you try to leave. Couple of responses. First of all, we think that even with monetary incentives, they're still not going to let these people leave no matter what, right? The defectors are still going to get beaten, as they claim, and like prevented from leaving, and we think that like all of these things are still going to happen under their model, even if they get money, right? Just because you have the money to leave doesn't mean that you have the means to be able to leave the community. That's something that they didn't tackle with. But furthermore, we would tell you, and we would argue that we don't actually think that most communities out there, most of these like cult organizations are as evil as they have you believe, but you would disagree, Michael?
If these groups are so horrible, why is it then that on the odd chance these people do get out, that you leave them out to dry and you don't help them in any meaningful capacity?
We don't actually think that that's the case, right? Like, we think that it's their choice to leave the group, and we think that once they left, they're no longer that group's responsibility. They should have no responsibility towards those people. Like, they're not living in their community anymore. We don't think that we're hanging them out to dry. It's just not their responsibility. Like, I turn 18 and I leave my parents. I'm not their responsibility anymore either, right? Okay, let's get back into like this idea about how it actually affects like reintegration. And what we tell you on your side opposition and under tax extension again, is that we think that instead of making it easier for defectors to leave, the side government would like to have you believe, we've told you that it's actually going to make it more difficult, right? Pat told you about this already. I've told you about this already in my whip speech. Why is it? They're going to become more isolationist groups, and they're going to be more like willing and like more capable of preventing people from leaving. This isn't a good thing. We don't want that. Okay, then in Michael's extension, I think that also Tot dealt with this really well and completely took down everything that he had to say. He like gave us this idea about how groups are going to be more lenient to like let people leave. We've told you, number one, not all these groups are evil. Number two, they're not going to let people leave if like they're going to spread hate speech. And number three, they're not going to get nicer because their religious creed prohibits them from doing so. Ladies and gentlemen, for all of these reasons, we are so proud to oppose. Thank you.